Welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how a general system of coplanar forces can be replaced with an equivalent force-coupled system and also show you the application of the concepts in solving a typical problem. Recall from the previous video that any force acting on a rigid body can be replaced with an equivalent force-coupled system at a specified point. Here in this diagram, we have a force F acting on the rigid body, and its point of application is the point A on the body. If we want the force to act at any other point, say point O, which is not on its line of action, then we have to add a couple of moment MO, which is equal to the moment of the original force F about point O. Also, the force of the equivalent force coupled system is same as the original force in terms of its magnitude and direction, and the couple's moment is equal to the moment of the original force about point O. So let's use this knowledge in simplifying a general system of coplanar forces. As you can see in this diagram, a rigid body is acted upon by three forces which form a system of coplanar and non-concurrent forces. All these forces, F1, F2, and F3, lie in the same plane. And if you extend their action lines backwards, you would notice that they do not meet at a single common point. And therefore, they form a non-concurrent system of forces. Now, in order to simplify this system of forces, we select a reference point, say point O, as you can see in the next diagram. We shift the point of application of force F1 from point A to point O, keeping its magnitude and direction unchanged. And in order to avoid any change in the effect of F1 on the body, we add a couple of moment M1, which is equal to the moment of force F1 about point O. We repeat this process for the other two forces too. In effect, we transform the original system of non-concurrent forces to a system of concurrent forces at point O and a system of moments, which you can see in this diagram. The moments M1, M2, and M3 are the moments of the original forces F1, F2, and F3 about point O. Now these concurrent forces can be added to obtain a resultant force R acting at point O. The vectors of all the moments are along an axis normal to the plane and can be algebraically added to get the net moment MO. In summary, I would like you to take note of these important points. The general system of coplanar forces can be reduced to a force-coupled system at any given point. 2. The force of the force-coupled system is the resultant R of the forces and is obtained by adding the various forces. And 3, the couple is obtained by adding the moments of the forces about point O. You will find the following equations quite handy in computing the resultant force R and the resultant moment MO. Now that we have covered the theoretical aspects, let us use these concepts and solve a typical problem. The plate in this problem is acted upon by four forces, and you can easily figure out that they form a system of coplanar, non-concurrent forces because all the forces lie in a single plane, and you can notice that while the action lines of the forces F2, F3, and F4 meet at a common point D, the action line of force F1 does not pass through D. So, this system of forces can be replaced with a force-coupled system at any point. And in this problem, we are required to find an equivalent force-coupled system at this point D. As you can see in this figure, we are supposed to determine the magnitude and direction of this force R and the resultant moment MO. In order to find the resultant force R, we have to imagine as if all the four forces are concurrent at point D as shown in this figure, and we shall determine the magnitude of the resultant force R from its horizontal and vertical components Rx and Ry. And we shall use the equation Rx is equal to sigma fx, which is the sum of x components of all the forces, and ry is equal to sigma fy, which is the sum of y components of all the forces. The force F1 is vertical and therefore has no component in x direction. Therefore, F1x will be 0. The second term is the x component of this force. From the geometry, we can make out that the slope of this force is 3 over 4 because AC upon CD is equal to 3 upon 4, and therefore the x component of this force, F2, would be minus 500 times 4 upon 5. The x component of the force F3 would be plus 340 times 8 upon 17. F4 is horizontal, pointing in minus x direction, therefore it will be minus 760, and this would work out to minus 400 plus 160 minus 760, and this will work out to minus 1000 Newton. This is the x component of the resultant force R. Let us now work out the y component of the resultant force R. This will be equal to F1y is 600 plus F2y is 500 times 3 upon 5. F3y is 340 times 15 upon 17 is 340 times 15 upon 17, and F4y is 0 because F4 is in x direction only. So we have on the right hand side 600 plus 300 plus 300, that is Ry will work out to 1200 Newtons. So the magnitude of the resultant force R would be equal to Rx square plus Ry square . This would work out to 1562 newtons, and the angle that this resultant would make with x-axis would be equal to tan theta would be equal to ry upon rx, that is 1200 upon 1000, and therefore this will mean theta is tan inverse 1.2, that is equal to 50.2 degrees. So the resultant force R is equal to 1562 newtons, and this angle theta, which it makes with the minus x axis, is equal to 50.2 degrees. Now, we need to compute the moment of all the forces about point D, and that will be equal to the moment of the couple, MD. Note that the forces F2, F3, and F4 pass through point D, and therefore would not cause any moment about point D. Nevertheless, the force F1 would cause a clockwise moment about point D, and the moment arm for this force would be 500 millimeters. That is, the moment of the couple, MD, will be equal to the moment of force F1 only, and that will be equal to 600 times 0.5 meter, which equals 300 Newton meter in clockwise direction. So, the force coupled system comprises of a resultant force R of magnitude 1562 Newtons, which makes an angle of 50.2 degrees with the minus X axis, and the moment of the couple is 300 Newton meter in clockwise direction. And this is our answer. That concludes the solution to the problem, but I would like to clarify one more point. In the coplanar cases, the resultant force vector R and the resultant moment vector MO are normal to each other, and in which case it is possible to further reduce the force coupled system to a single force. But that is the topic of my next video. So, that's it, and thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.